ericmuadet.com. Let's take a look at why, when markets are trending lower across the globe, it's good practice to take a look at what other markets are doing, because sometimes they can give you an idea as to what might happen in whatever market you're trading. For example, let's take a look at the Nifty, which was down overnight about 1.6%. And you can see here, we had been expecting a pullback because coming into the end of the past week, it had broken initially here and was coming back to back test this blue line. Now that was resistance, and of course we can see after hitting those levels, it did come off the highs and down 1.6 at the close. Now that is one view from one market, and also there's another view which we had noticed it was coming back to test the top side of a declining RSI resistance line. And also keep in mind here, I'm using RSI period of 26. So just in case this looks different from yours. Now, what I want to stress here is it tends to be that markets tend to have the same type of charts, especially on the way down. For example, take a look at the FTSE. Right now, the FTSE is setting up almost similar to that of the Nifty, coming back right now, stalling at the close of Tuesday's action, hitting that level. More than likely, if that resistance remains, then it might follow the Nifty short term for a pullback lower based on this chart. Now we can also see the similar type action if you take a look at the Canadian market live right now, coming back to test the previous break level right there, coming off the break of late December here. And of course, after breaking here, we broke from those levels and would immediately, or over a couple of days, drift lower. So we are coming back to test this level. Recently, it was resistance at those highs, and now we are hitting that level there. More than likely, somewhere around here, this could easily become a stall. Again, the stall at this RSI level would suggest that, just like the Nifty, day to day, the next move, short term, might be lower. Now, couple that with the S&P 500 live trading, and you can see it's coming back to test a break of late December also here. So that break took place here with the S&P trading at 2080 in that range. And now since then, at the highs of late January, early February, those were the highs, hit that level, hit close to that red line, the highs there. And right now we are dancing with this red line. Now this happens to be slightly below 61.8, so resistance here on the hourly RSI would suggest that more than likely we might be looking to follow the Nifty lower. The moral here is, when we are trading across the globe with markets pointing down, it makes sense to watch other markets, especially on a smaller time frame, especially when the VIX is trading above 20, which means that smaller time frames tend to be more in control. Eric Muadet, muadet.com. As always, good luck, peace, and blessings. ECS.